Today we're going to be taking a look at the best trailer hitches available for the 2017 Toyota Sienna. Now the hitches we're going to look at today are all Class 3 hitches. That makes them extremely versatile. They work out really well for cargo carriers, for bike racks, just about any type of hitch accessory out there. The first one we're going to look at is part number E98853. This is going to be a hidden cross tube style hitch. Then we're looking at Draw-Tite part number 76112. Finally, we have a exposed cross tube hitch. We'll get into the details of that in just a minute. Its part number is E98837. Now during our video, we're gonna go over each of the hitches pretty specifically. We're gonna talk about safety chain connection points, pinholes, weight ratings, things along those lines. If that doesn't interest you at all, we can kind of cut right to the chase for you and just get it out of the way up front. If you're looking for a hitch for recreational use, which means cargo carriers, bike racks, things of that nature, and you want a nice clean look, I think the e-trailer hitch with the hidden cross tube is the way to go. This stays completely hidden behind the bumper. All you're gonna see is the receiver tube opening. Now the matte finish is my personal favorite. I really like the finish. It seems to be very resilient. So if I were picking a hitch for mine, that would be the one, E98853. If you're looking for something that's easier to install, easier to get on your vehicle with no modifications at all, my second runner-up for that category, if, like I said, if I were picking a hitch, this would be the one going on my Sienna. But the second one would be the second e-trailer hitch that we have, part number E98837. This is going to require no modifications to the vehicle at all. The thing I like about this one is that you're going to be able to more easily do this in your driveway, let's say, than this one. The thing I don't like about this hitch, from this point right here, all the way across to the other side, you're going to see that entire cross tube. So if that matters to you, I think I take a little bit more effort, go with one of the hidden cross tubes. If not, if you just want something to get on your vehicle, that's going to be a good way to go. As far as towing goes, I think the Draw-Tite kind of shines here simply because it has that wiring bracket attached. And if you're only going to be using your hitch to haul a trailer, you don't care how far that ball mount is underneath the back of the vehicle. And if you decide to run your wiring outside, I think having that bracket to attach to would be nice. Now, if that didn't answer your questions and you're still here, let's get into them a little bit further. Basically, with these two hitches, with our e-trailer and with our Draw-Tite, we kind of hinted to it before. Most of what you see is going to be completely hidden. This is a big change when it comes to Sienna hitches. Back in the day, we only had this option. We're going to have that cross tube all the way across the bottom and our receiver tube openings a little bit closer to the ground. Whereas with our new hidden hitches like this, we're able to get that receiver tube up a little bit closer to the bumper in the back. It buys us a little bit extra space, which these are going to be 11 to 13 inches off the ground. So any kind of room we can get is important, but also the look is so much better. It really is a very nice looking hitch on the back of the vehicle. Only having that receiver tube sticking out, it gives a much more factory type appearance. Now we'll talk a little bit more about the finish quality. You'll see here on the Draw-Tite hitch, it has that very high gloss finish. We're used to seeing this finish on most hitches that have been produced. They tend to hold up fairly well, but over time, you are gonna have rusting, you're gonna have dings, you're gonna have stuff like that with them. It's just part of the hitch being on the back of the vehicle. When we look at the carbide finish, this is going to do a much better job of hiding any scratches or little imperfections that we might get. And I really like that satin or that matte look on the back of a vehicle. It's going to blend in a lot more with your tires, trim, and things like that. We generally see trim that looks more like this than we do high gloss kind of trim on vehicles. Now all of our hitches offer a 5/8 diameter pinhole. That's what we're going to use to secure our items in place. All of them are going to have plenty of room, so anti-rattle devices are going to work out really well. Locking hitch pins won't be a problem. And of course, standard pins and clips, you'll have no issues at all getting those installed. Now, one thing you'll notice here on the Draw-Tite, here's our 5/8 diameter pinhole. That's what we use to secure all of our items in place with. Just behind it here, closer to the rear of the vehicle, you'll see another one. It's a little bit smaller. We never want to use that to secure any of our items with. That's for the J-pin stabilization system, which is just one form of many different types of anti-rattle device available. And once we have an item put in our hitch, and we secure that down, we eliminate a lot of the movement. So that's going to reduce noise, rattle, and any of that energy being felt inside the vehicle. The Draw-Tite also offers an attachment point that's been welded onto the hitch already. This is going to be for attaching 4-pole or 7-pole wiring. You have 3 pre-drilled holes there for that. Now, one thing to keep in mind with that being said, though, the wiring with the Sienna is typically going to live inside the rear hatch of the vehicle. We pull it out when we need it, put it back in when we don't. So in order to utilize this, you're going to have to run your wiring outside of the vehicle using a grommet or something like that. So that's kind of going to be up to you. The flange or the bracket is already on there, but something else to keep in mind, you can add one to either of the e-trailer hitches using either our universal short or universal long bracket. Now let's talk about the weight ratings of each of the hitches. With the e-trailer hidden behind the bumper type hitch, it's going to offer a tongue weight rating of 525 pounds. So that's the maximum downward force we can put here at the receiver tube opening. And it gives us a 3,500 pound gross trailer weight rating. So that's going to be right in line with the Sienna's max capacity. Looking at the Draw-Tite, that tongue weight rating is going to go up to 525 pounds. The gross trailer weight rating, it's going to be at 3,500. And then finally, with the e-trailer that remains exposed, it has a tongue weight rating of 350 with a gross trailer weight rating of 3,500 pounds, just like the other three. Now, the Draw-Tite and the e-trailer are both rated for use with weight distribution as well. The tongue weight rating is going to stay the same at 525. The gross trailer weight rating stays the same at 3,500 with the Draw-Tite. With the e-trailer, the tongue weight rating is going to go up to 500 and the gross trailer weight is going to go up to 5,000. Keep in mind, though, you do not want to exceed the capacity of your Sienna, so check the owner's manual and use whichever number is the lowest. Another minor difference that we have, you can see on the e-trailer that remains exposed, it has a plate-style safety chain connection point. Pretty good width there. Should be able to get just about any size chain you're going to want to use with the Sienna connected. Although looking at the Draw-Tite and the e-trailer that remain hidden behind, you can see it's just a little bit more wide and open. Now, one of the things that really draws me to the e-trailer hidden hitch is the clearance that we have. From the receiver tube opening here to the ground, we've got about 13 inches, whereas with the Draw-Tite, we'll have 12, and with the e-trailer exposed, that's gonna be 11. Now, as far as usable space, so when we put a bike rack in or we put a cargo carrier in, the way we determine that is from the center of the pinhole to the outermost edge of the bumper. With the e-trailer, it's going to be the furthest out. It's at 4¾ inches. The Draw-Tite's going to be at 5 inches, so it's about 1/4 inch further in. And with the e-trailer that remains exposed, it's going to be underneath the vehicle 6 inches. So basically what that's going to mean to you, cargo carriers, bike racks, if you want to fold those up toward the rear of the vehicle, by having that pinhole further out, it's going to allow us to do that more easily. And that's going to complete our look at the best trailer hitches available for the Toyota Sienna.